The normal altitude was 85,000 feet.
Wow.
Okay? And so this is what it looks like out of your window at 85,000 feet.
Wow.
You can see the curvature of the earth here, and you can see that the blue haze is the atmosphere. So you're above about 97%
so
of the earth's atmosphere.
So it breaks the atmosphere then.
And you can see space. So you're flying 2,200 miles an hour, which is faster than a 30-06 rifle bullet coming out of the muzzle of the gun.
Wow.
And these are the kind of pictures you could take from that altitude and that speed.
Wow.
So this is the old Seattle Kingdom that's been torn down since then. But so this was designed and brought back in the 1960s, early 60s. So you can imagine what we can do today, but that was pretty good for 1960s
right?
And film cameras.
Ask your
awesome.
Question again, Dad. What were you asking?
The U-2 spy plane.
The U-2 was preceded this.
Right.
Yeah.
So the reason we built the Blackbird was really because the U-2 was shot down with Francis Gary
right.
Powers over Moscow or near Moscow in 1960, and so they tried to make the U-2 more stealthy, but the technology didn't allow it. They did make a version called the YS-12. They made three of those. Before the SR-71, and they were designed to carry missiles, modified Falcon missiles, and the intent was to fly them very high, and they would spot the enemy bombers coming down at a lower altitude and shoot down at them rather than trying to take off and shoot them. So it would be an upside down interceptor.
Right,
and they
right.
tested that out, and it worked fine, but the planes were so expensive and so super secret at the time, the Air Force didn't buy any.
It did work. Yeah, if this thing slowed down after a shot of missile, it'd shoot
something. Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Thank you. That's
what Kukoff did.
He was the engineer of the, he built the engines of C-130s.
He's
supposed to be in here. This is where he was heading. Unless he went back to find mom.
Hi guys. I'm a docent, so I'm here to answer your question. Hey ma'am, do you have a question?
Yes, that's what it was, but I wasn't sure.
This is the John Glenn training couch. Look at all the vintage related toys. That is hilarious.
How many of these did your dad have?
Did you have any of these, Dad?
All of them.
He probably wishes he had all of them when he was a kid.
Yeah, I like the guns, all the space guns and all. That's pretty cool.
I had that one.
Did you?
Yeah. And that one. Maybe that one, I'm not sure about it.
Got a reflection here in the middle.
I had some of the Star Wars.
I'm sure the real thing lit up and all that, you know.
Right.
Got them kind of lights in it.
That's so cool. Which one is that?
The Redstone.
Oh, the Redstone. This one.
Is that Rolex?
What? Oh yeah, it's a Rolex clock. I didn't see that before.
Love getting fried.
You want a picture in front of it?
Sure. I'm sure the skin is very thin.
Yep.
It's got to be lightweight.
All right, Brian, take our picture.
Probably not taking it.
That landed on Flyers.
It's over there.
Around that display case on the other side of that wall right there.
Let me know. Yeah.
Why are the planes covered up?
Because we're redoing the roof. So they're in this middle section now, doing the roof, so we have to protect them.
Oh, I see.
Just in case stuff drops.
But,
yeah, it's a long needed repair. We've been fighting with leaks over the last 5-6 years. So,
oh, really? Okay.
Going anywhere? Where?
a bad pilot.
Yes.
I'm on the plane, it's a bit far.
You're probably on.